Financial leverage. So when we are discussing about financial leverage, we need to understand that when can we say that a firm is financially leveraged, or when can we say that there is the presence of financial leverage in the firm. So if a firm's capital structure is formed with the help of fixed income securities, we can say that the firm is financially leveraged. A firm's capital structure can be formed by raising funds from any sources. If a firm is only focusing on or only depending upon the equity shares to raise its capital, then we can say that that firm is not financially leveraged because there is no presence of fixed income securities in that particular firm's capital structure. What do you mean by fixed income securities? Fixed income securities means those securities which demands a fixed rate of return. For example, debenture, bond, preference shares, etc. Bonds and debentures, we know that the interest rate is fixed and at a particular rate the firm wants to pay to its shareholder, to its investors. And in the case of preference share also, the dividend is fixed. So the firm needs to pay at a rate, fixed dividend rate to the shareholders. So a fixed rate is there for those securities. So such securities like preference shares, debentures and bonds is known as fixed income securities. While equity shares is not a fixed income security because the dividend rate is not fixed. So when we are discussing about financial leverage, a firm is financially leveraged if there is the presence of fixed income security in the capital structure. So we can see the meaning of financial leverage. The firm's ability to use the fixed financial charges or to magnify the effect of changes in earnings before interest and tax on firm's earnings per share. I will make it simpler. It is the firm's ability to use the fixed income securities for the purpose of magnify the change in earnings per share by the changes in the EBIT. So here also, in order to understand the concept of financial leverage, you need to identify and you need to see three factors, three important things. The firm ability to use the fixed income securities. That means the fixed income securities, we already discussed that it may be debentures, it may be bonds, or it may be preference shares. So the firm's ability to use all these fixed income securities, for what purpose they are using? By using these fixed income securities, they are trying to magnify the change in earnings per share due to the small changes made in the earnings before interest and tax, that is EBIT. So a small change in EBIT will leads to a big change in earnings per share due to the firm's ability to use the fixed income securities. So that is known as financial leverage. So if a firm is using fixed income securities or fixed financial charges, then the firm is financially leveraged. For what purpose it is using? The firm is using these fixed income securities in order to bring a magnified change in the earnings per share by making small changes in the EBIT. So that is known as financial leverage. So there are two cases for financial leverage. The financial leverage can be favorable financial leverage and unfavorable financial leverage. The favorable financial leverage is known as trading on equity. So always it is says that the financial leverage is a double-edged sword, because the financial leverage should be used wisely. Sometimes it may be useful for the firm, sometimes it will be very bad to use the financial leverage because it will bring many losses. So there is favorable financial leverage and unfavorable financial leverage. Favorable financial leverage is known as trading on equity. So let's discuss about this favorable financial leverage or trading on equity. We know that the fixed income securities, if a firm is using fixed income securities, definitely the firm needs to pay at a fixed rate to its investors. For example, if a firm is issuing 9% debentures, then definitely the firm is using that 9% debenture, that means that fixed income security, for 9%. So the firm is liable to pay an interest at the rate of 9% to the employer, to the investor. So if a firm is able to make an earning which is greater than this 9%, then we can say that the firm is having a favorable financial leverage. I will make it simpler. If a firm is making an earning at a rate which is greater than the rate which is fixed income security, then we can say that the firm is having a favorable financial leverage. So that is known as trading on equity. Consider another example. If a firm is issuing a bond for 10%, so that means the firm is liable to pay an interest at 10% to the investors. So by using that fixed income security, if the firm is able only to make an earning of 6%, then it is not a favorable financial leverage, because the firm is using the fixed income security bond and the bond percentage is 10%. So the cost of using that fixed income security is 10%, and by using that particular fixed income security at 10%, the firm is only able to make an earning only at the rate of 6%. So that is a case of unfavorable financial leverage. So that is not good. If it is favorable financial leverage, it is good. So by using a fixed income security, if a firm is able to make an earning which is greater than the rate of that fixed income security, then it is known as favorable financial leverage and it is known as trading on equity. So financial leverage, the formula is EBIT divided by EBT. That means earning before tax. Another formula is also there, EBIT divided by EBT minus preference dividend divided by 1 minus tax rate. The commonly used formula for financial leverage is this one, that is EBIT divided by EBT. So we can move on to the next part, that is the degree of financial leverage. The degree of financial leverage, the commonly used formula is these two ones. The percentage change in EPS due to the percentage change in EBIT. That's we already discussed in this part. They are using these fixed income securities for the purpose of making small changes in this EBIT, they need to magnify the change in earnings per share. So by making small changes, they are using this fixed income security for the purpose by making small changes in EBIT, they need to bring magnified change in EPS. For that purpose, they are using the financial leverage, or they are using the fixed income securities. So please remember this formula: degree of financial leverage is equal to percentage change in EPS divided by percentage change in EBIT. So that's all about the financial degree of financial leverage. Now we can see the main features of financial leverage. It is somewhat which is opposite to the operating leverage. We know that operating leverage, it is related to fixed cost, and fixed cost is associated with fixed asset. So definitely it comes on the asset side of the balance sheet. But here the financial leverage, it is related to the liability side of the balance sheet. Why it comes in the liability side? Because financial leverage means the use of fixed income securities. So the fixed income securities will always give a liability to the firm to pay a rate, to pay at a particular fixed rate to the investors. So that's why it is something which is comes under the liability side of the balance sheet. and it is the mix of method. It is the mix of method of financing. Definitely, we are discussing about the fixed income securities. So we are discussing about preference shares, debentures, bonds, etc. So if in the capital structure, if there is a presence of preference shares, debentures, or bonds, then we can say that the capital structure or the firm is financially leveraged. So it is something which is related to financing, because we are normally uses these ways like bonds, debentures, and preference shares for financing our firm. And it shows the effect of changes in operating profit, EBIT, on the earnings per share due to the fixed financial charges, as we already discussed. It shows the effect of changes in operating profit or EBIT on earnings per share. So this financial leverage is used, or it is termed as, by the usage of this fixed financial securities, it shows the effect of change in operating profit on the earnings per share. So what effect is caused on the earnings per share due to the small changes in the EBIT. And it involves financial risk because it is completely related to financing.